Well, family members are raising concerns about their loved ones in prison, and now there is a petition to reduce overcrowding during this pandemic. TwoWorks View's Katie Kelleher spoke with those working to make some changes.
They didn't receive death sentences. And unfortunately, some of those may pay that price.
Jonna Wolf's fiance, Griffin Davison, has been at the Dick Connor Correctional Center for nearly 2 years. She typically talks to him every day, but hasn't heard from him since Saturday.
And the fact that I haven't got a phone call is the most terrifying time. And we've been through riots. You know, we've been through lockdowns.
She says they're both worried about the prison facilities during the coronavirus pandemic. So she's been writing to top Oklahoma officials looking for answers.
Because of all the other competing concerns of a public health crisis, these people that have already essentially been granted a sentence reduction are just sitting in there being exposed potentially to a virus.
Inmates now remain in their cells except for necessary services and are being given bars of soap and masks. But Colleen McCarty is hoping to do more. She started a petition to get the Oklahoma Pardon and Parole Board to reduce the prison population. She says the board is already reviewing 500 commutation applications next week, but that won't be enough.
What inmates have been tested? How many? What is the protocol? Who gets tested?
She's also asking that the board members work more than the 4 days a month they currently do, and more resources for investigators and staff. Meanwhile, Wolf's fiance is supposed to be released in August. Until then, she and McCarty will use their voices, hoping that will be sooner.
If we sit back and do nothing, we are failing them because they cannot be heard from in there.
If you'd like to check out the petition or the Facebook page for it, you can find those links in this story on our website, KGRH.com. Katie Kelleher, TwoWorks for You.